قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب.
My fellow Muslims, perceive that a guest was coming to you, and this guest was one who was of great nobility, one who gives, one possessing much khair with him. What would be your position, or how would your feelings be towards this guest, and how you would welcome him? Without a doubt, we would make much preparations. Preparations to receive this guest, how to welcome them, and how to achieve and gain from that person the good that they had with them. فَهَا نَحْنُ فِي سَدَدِ اسْتِقْبَالِ ضَيْفٍ عَظِيمٍ. And here we are as Muslims, about to welcome a great guest. And this guest is nothing more and none other than the month of Ramadan. As this is the last Jumu'ah before the entering of the month of Ramadan upon us. And the people, in welcoming the month of Ramadan, there are different categories. And they have different ways that they welcome the month of Ramadan. From them are those who the month of Ramadan and the other months are equal. They can continue how they were. If they were shortcoming, they continue in their shortcomings. If they were sinful, they continue in their sins. If they were doing wrong, then they tread that path of wrong that they were upon. And the month enters, and the month exits, and there is no change in their life. And it is as if they have been told that the keys to the Jannah, you have them. وَعِيَذٍ بِاللَّهِ. And they're from the people, those who the month of Ramadan enters upon them, and they take advantage of this opportunity. They strive in rectifying their souls. They strive in implementing the khair that will make them enter the Jannah of Allah Azza wa Jal. And these are the ones who are successful. As this month of Ramadan, it is an opportunity. And we, when welcoming this month as Muslims, should feel farah, we should be happy that the month of Allah Azza wa Jal, the blessed month of Ramadan, is upon us. As the Messenger told us, جاءكم شهر رمضان المبارك. As it has come to you, the blessed month of Ramadan. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He tells us in the Noble Quran, قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون. And say to them, and the mercy of Allah and His giving and His bounty, take rejoice in this. This is better than all of that which they accumulate. So without a doubt, this month it is from the mercy of Allah and His blessing and His giving to the Muslims. So it is upon us to feel happy that Allah Azza wa Jal, He has given us this month. It is upon us to feel this delight. ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَذِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ. And that is that the one who magnifies the symbols and the rights of Allah, then this indicates the taqwa that he has in his heart. So let us feel happiness that Allah, He has chosen this ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with this month. And let us visualize and realize this. As many of the people, this month comes and they see themselves in a state of sorrow. They see themselves as if they are being punished. They see themselves as being deprived from food and drink. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, He is doing this, as He has told us in the Noble Quran, for a great hikmah and a wisdom. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ السِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Oh, you who believe, the fasting has been prescribed for you, as it has been prescribed for the people who came before you, so that you may be pious. So the greatest reason for the fasting of this month, it's for us to achieve the piety of Allah Azza wa Jal. What does Allah Azza wa Jal want with our punishment? What does Allah Azza wa Jal want to deprive us of food and drink? And there's no gain in it. But with difficulty, there comes ease. And with hardship, there comes this taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal, which we are meant to achieve as Muslims in this month. So this is the reason for it. And people, they are different in welcoming this month. You find from those who are sinful and transgressive upon the earth, they say, I'm going to drink as much khamar as I can drink from the alcohol, and I'm going to use as much drugs as possible so that when the month comes, I will be able to have enough in my system that will make it easy for me to continue the month. And what kind of heedlessness and what kind of sin and transgression has the shaitan cast in the heart of this person when he wishes to welcome the month of Allah Azza wa Jal, Ramadan, with sin? What kind of blackness has the heart swallowed and become engulfed by for a person to do such a thing like this? This month it requires from us, Ma'ashir al-Muslimin, that we do tanafus, welcome this month by racing towards good deeds. Race towards good deeds in this month. As Allah Azza wa Jal, He told us that this Jannah, which we are here day and night as Muslims trying to achieve, it requires from us racing. وَفِي ذَٰلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. And in that, let those who race, race. This Jannah requires from us striving. This is a sil'ah. This is the product, the commodity of Allah Azza wa Jal. أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ الْجَنَّةِ. This product of the and commodity of Allah, it is a Jannah. And it is ghaliyah. It is of great value with Allah Azza wa Jal. So we are in need, my brothers in Islam, that we are striving in this month. If a person he has with him from the dunya, and Allah Azza wa Jal, He has granted that person, whether he's a Muslim or non-Muslim, from mass amounts of wealth, you find those who have wealth with them striving in trying to reach that person. Day and night, their efforts in the dunya is, how can I reach that person? How can I surpass him? How can I have more wealth than him? And where are we with regard to the striving for the Jannah of Allah Azza wa Jal? My brothers in Islam, this is an opportunity in welcoming the month of Ramadan by knowing that the one who this month enters upon him and it passes him and he has not been forgiven of his sins, then he is in great danger. Know, my brother in Islam, that our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has invoked and made dua against a person who this month enters and the month exits and he has not been forgiven. It is reported by Ahmed in his Musnad and Ibn Khuzaym and others from the hadith of Abi Huraira, and the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sa'id al-minbar faqala ameen, ameen, ameen. It is reported by Ahmed and others from the hadith of Abi Huraira that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he boarded the minbar and he said ameen 3 times. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they said, mal ameen, what is this ameen? O Messenger of Allah, that you are saying. And he said to them sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ja'ani Jibreel faqala, ya Muhammad, man adrakahu shahr Ramadan, or man adraka shahr Ramadan, falam yughfar lah, fadakhala an-nar, ab'adahu Allah, qul ameen. He said, O Muhammad, the month of Ramadan, the one who meets it, and the month exits, and he has not been forgiven for his sins, and he enters the hellfire, ab'adahu Allah. May Allah Azza wa Jal distance him. And the Messenger said, ameen. Wa qala Jibreel alayhi salam, من أدرك أبويه أو أحدهما في الكبر فلم يبر بهما فلم يغفر له فدخل النار فأبعده الله. He said, O Messenger of Allah, the one who meets his two parents in old age, or he meets one of them and he does not show piety and righteousness to his parents and he enters the hellfire, then may Allah distance him. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying ameen. And third of these people that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also invoked against, that he said ameen towards the one who the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned and he does not say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he enters the hellfire, may Allah distance him in the hellfire. And the Messenger again said ameen upon this dua. So these are 3 categories of people. And the intent behind this hadith that we wish to mention is the first of these categories, the one who the month of Ramadan enters and he is not forgiven of his sins and he enters the hellfire, may Allah distance him. And this is the best of the prophets. And the angel who's making this dua is the best of the angels, Jibreel alayhi salam. And how many of us could be in this state that past Ramadan, we were not forgiven of our sins. And it could be a reason that we are entering the hellfire, wa'iyadun billah. And the curse of Jibreel and the dua of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is landing upon us. So from the ways of meeting and welcoming the month of Ramadan as a believer is to know, O you who Muslim, that if this month exits this month and you're not forgiven of your sins, then know that there is a dua that the Messenger he has made against us. So we should be striving in the maghfirah of Allah, seeking for Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive us of our sins. And from the ways that we are capable of welcoming the month of Ramadan is to know that Allah Azza wa Jal, he is doing us a favor and he is giving us a blessing in this month. Throughout the year, these other 11 months, the shayateen, the marada, and the other great demons, they are left on the loose for them to put the people to trial. And in this month of Ramadan, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is telling us that these demons are locked up. That when the month of Ramadan enters, he tells us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أغلقت أبواب النيران وفتحت أبواب الجنة وصفدت الشياطين وفي رواية سلسلة. It is in the Sahihain from the hadith of Abu Huraira that when this month enters, the doors of the hellfire are closed and the doors of Jannah, they're open, and the demons, they're tied up and they're fettered in chains. And these are the great demons, the marada, as it comes in the Sunan. So know, by the welcoming of this month of Ramadan, it's for you to know that Allah Azza wa Jal, he is having a mercy upon you, tying for you this enemy to make it easier upon you to do ibadah. And this is a gift from Allah Azza wa Jal to this ummah, that Allah Azza wa Jal, he is tying these shayateen from us. If one of you was told that the greatest of your enemies, he is being tied up for you in chains, for you to escape from his evil, how much happiness would enter you, my fellow Muslim? How much relief would you find in that? That your enemy who wants your destruction, he is being tied up in chains so that you may escape from his evil and his harm. And Allah Azza wa Jal, Rabbul Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, he is having mercy upon this ummah by tying these devils to give you another opportunity and a second wind to strive in implementing the good deeds while your enemy is tied up. This one month that you have in you, that strength to do good deeds. We see in the month of Ramadan that many of the Muslims, even those who Allah Azza wa Jal has tested with being weak, you find them striving in the month of Ramadan. The masajid, they are more full. The Quran is more recited than any other time throughout the year. The more sadaqah is given more in that time than any other time of the year. And all of this is because of Allah Azza wa Jal's mercy upon us. The closing of the doors of the hellfire, the opening of the doors of the Jannah, and Allah Azza wa Jal tying and fettering these shayateen. So take advantage of this month, my fellow Muslim, and welcome it with happiness and a decisive change in your life, that you will be moving towards Allah Azza wa Jal and His pleasure. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make us from those who benefit from this month, and that the month does not pass except that we are forgiven of our sins. This month of Ramadan, it requires from us a proper welcoming, a noble month and a blessed month with much virtues. And every year around these times and in the month of Ramadan, we hear the likes of these reminders, but it is few from us that take heed. So let this year be the year that you take heed and that you change your life for Allah Azza wa Jal's sake and His pleasure. Be one who is from the people of khair, the one who has overcome his soul, the one who Allah Azza wa Jal is pleased with and enters him into paradise. Not long ago we heard in some of the masajid that we're praying salah in, an individual reminding some of the people with regard to this month. And he brought an analogy which was mistaken. He said to the people who were there this month of Ramadan, imagine if a person was going to give you 100 pounds one day and the rest of the year he gives you 1 pound. Would you take that, or would you take that 1 pound that day and the rest of the year take 100 pounds? And he's comparing the second example to the month of Ramadan. You take 1 pound today and the rest of the year taking 100. Meaning you're capable of doing other things that the month of Ramadan you could not do. And this is mistaken without any doubt. And this month of Ramadan, it is a month to achieve the piety of Allah Azza wa Jalla and His taqwa. It is not a time that you strive in it this one month and the rest of the year is done. You go back to how you were. But it is an opening for you to change your life. It is an opportunity that Allah is giving us to achieve His taqwa and His piety. And with this, there requires from us welcoming this month with a decisive niyyah, a strong will to change our lives. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us in the hadith of Abi Hurairah in the Sunan, and it is also reported from Ibn Umar, that he said, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ لَيْسَ مِنْ سِيَامِهِ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ سِيَامِهِ إِلَّا الْجُوعِ. How many are those who fast, they do not get from their fast except hunger. وَرُبَّ قَائِمٍ لَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْ قِيَامِهِ إِلَّا السَّهَرِ. And how many are those who stand for the salah, and they're not gaining from the salah except sahar, they're losing sleep. This shows us these people, the month entered upon them, they fast. The month entered upon them, they stood in Qiyam al-Layl. But they did not make a strong will in really rectifying themselves. This month should not be a month of taqleed, blind following. The Muslims are fasting, I'm going to fast. The Muslims are reading Qur'an, I'm going to read Qur'an. This is a month of achieving taqwa. This taqwa that stems from you turning back to Allah Azza wa Jal, first and foremost, mostly with repentance and all of that which has passed. And we heard in the previous week the importance of the tawbah and striving to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal from the sins that we do. So this month, it is an opportunity for this tawbah, that we repent to Allah Azza wa Jal, min al-dhunubi saghiriha wa kabiriha, from the major sins and the minor sins. All of this that we have been doing throughout these 11 months, that we know from the sins that we have been doing oppression to our own souls over, that we should be striving in rectifying them. This month of Ramadan is an opportunity for this. And from the ways of welcoming this month, my fellow Muslim, it's for you to know that Allah Azza wa Jal in this month, He has chosen the best of worship, from the best actions of worship rather, to be done in this month. This month of Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jal, He could have obligated upon the Muslims any other action of worship. But Allah, He chose particularly the fasting. As it comes in the Sahihain from the hadith of Abi Hurairah, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us that Allah Azza wa Jal said, كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنُ آدَمْ لَهُ إِلَّا السَّوْمِ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. He said, Allah Azza wa Jal, which is a hadith Qudsi, that all of the actions of the son of Adam, they are for him, except the fasting, for indeed it is for me, and I am the one who repays for it. So the Allah Azza wa Jal, He chose in this month the action of worship which is for Him, Jalla wa Ala, that He rewards in the manner that He sees, Allah Jalla wa Ala. And this month, this fasting, it is a ibadah for Allah Azza wa Jal, because many of the people, they fast, and you will not know from them, most of the people, that they are fasting. You will not hear the person telling you that he is fasting, and you will not know that he is fasting. So it is the action of worship which is between him and the Creator, as opposed to the salah that we are praying, the people can see you. As opposed to the sadaqah that we're giving, the people may know about it. But when you are fasting, this is between you and your Creator, Jalla wa Ala. And He knows the ab'ad, the level of taqwa that you are trying to achieve in this worship that you are doing. So Allah Azza wa Jal, He has chosen in this month, this action of worship. And it is upon us to know that this is from the greatest actions of worship. There is a purification for us from the deeds that we are doing of evil. And it is a muqawama, a striving and an overcoming of our souls. As if we fast, this gives us an opportunity to realize that our souls, we are incapable of overcoming him. The one who was mubtala, he is tested with cigarettes or drugs or other things, that he knows that he is capable of leaving it off. And it is an opportunity for him to make tawbah from this sin that he is doing. The one who was coming up short in his salawat, he realizes that he is capable of doing it. So he strives in it. All of these actions of worship, they are coming through this ease that Allah Azza wa Jal has given us in this month. And to welcome this month requires from us striving. This month of Sha'ban, which we are almost finishing, from the ways of welcoming was to fast. As it comes in the hadith of Aisha, which is in the Sahihain, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam kana yasum akthar al-Sha'ban. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he would fast most of the month of Sha'ban. And this month, it is a welcoming and a practice for you. The times that we live in today in this country, that we are fasting over 18 hours sometimes, sometimes a bit less than this. So you are getting an opportunity to strive and practice, so that when the month enters upon you, you've already become used to the fasting. And this is without a doubt from the sunnah of our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he used to increase in the month of Sha'ban. So we have few days which are left. From us are those who did not fast the month, and they're waiting for Ramadan to enter. So take advantage, my brother in Islam. This month of Ramadan, these few days, which have been left before we enter it from Sha'ban, let us strive in fasting. And this is from welcoming the month of Ramadan upon khair. And as a benefit, we mentioned that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us in the hadith of Abu Huraira fi Sahih, do not proceed the month of Ramadan with fasting 1 or 2 days before Ramadan. So those last 2 days before Ramadan enters, we should not fast. Unless a person, he has days to make up from the past Ramadan. Or a person, he made for himself a sunnah of fasting Monday and Thursday, or 3 times a month, which he's capable of fasting. So fast and strive in it. Otherwise, we should not fast those 2 days before the month of Ramadan. And from the welcoming of this month, is what this hadith goes on to mention. When the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us that Allah azza wa jal, he has said, فَإِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ صَوْمِ أَحَدِكُمْ فَلَا يَرْفُثْ وَلَا يَفْسُقْ. If it is the day of fasting for one of you that he fasts, then let him not do any rafath. This is the muqaddimat al-jima', speech about having relations with your wife and so on, things of temptation and flirting. These aspects, they should not be done when you are fasting. And this is something that we may come up short in. As a person, he finds in himself this shahwa and this desire. So he says certain things, or he acts upon a certain action, which in this month of Ramadan, and when the person is fasting, we should be holding back from this rafath. وَلَا يَفْسُقْ. And he should not fall into sin and rebellious actions. وَلَا يَسْخُبْ. And he should not raise his voice. فَإِنْ سَابَهُ أَحَدْ. And if a person was to speak to him in a manner which is belittling him or he curses him, فَلْيَقُلْ إِنِّي مْرُؤٌ صَائِمٌ. Then let him say, I am a person who is fasting. I am a person who is fasting. إِخْوَانِ فِي اللَّهِ. This month is an opportunity to implement all of these deeds and others, striving against the things that we may be saying, the things we may be doing, the temptations of our soul. Let us welcome this month as true believers. And this month of fasting, our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us, it is found in the Sunan and is authenticated by Al-Alamatul Wadi'i, that this fasting of 3 days in a month, it gets rid of wahru sadr, which is the ghil, the rancor, the ill wills, the enmity that a person he may carry in his chest. If a person fasts, the Messenger is telling us, 3 times a month, it eliminates this. What then do we perceive of fasting an entire month from this khair? And if you're fasting the whole month, this will be a greater reason that it is wiped away. Ikhwani fillah, this month, we should welcome it by, as we've mentioned, having decisive and a strong will and not returning back to how we were as Muslims. This is an opportunity Allah has given us. And we are hoping that what we are saying is reaching, it is reaching hearts which are open and not hearts which are closed. As the whole purpose and the benefit of these reminders that we are hearing on the Fridays and these Jum'ah is for us to benefit something that will push us forward in our lives. And it is not that we are coming and we are listening to these khutab and we are listening to the muhadarat and our hearts have become so overwhelmed with the dunya that it is entering one ear and exiting and we are not being affected. My brothers in Islam, this month, it is a gift from Allah. It is a gift from your Creator. It is an opportunity for you to change your life. And we have a few days which have left. So strive, my brother in Islam, in welcoming this month of Ramadan. Do this khair for yourself. As our life as believers, it should not increase us except in khair. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in the hadith of Abi Huraira fi Muslim, وَاجْعَلِ الْحَيَاةَ زِيَادَةً لِي فِي كُلِّ خَيْرٍ. Oh Allah, make my life for me an increase in all good. وَاجْعَلِ الْمَوْتَ رَاحَةً لِي مِن كُلِّ شَرٍ. And oh Allah, make my death an ease and a relaxation and enjoyment from all difficulty. نسأل الله عز وجل أن ينفعنا بما سمعنا وأن يجعل هذا الشهر المبارك شهر رمضان المقبل إلينا شهرا شهر توبة وشهرا للمغفرة وشهرا للخير وشهرا للإقدام والإقبال على ربنا. ونسأل الله عز وجل أن يرحم المسلمين أينما كانوا من المستضعفين في سوريا وفي فلسطين وفي اليمن وفي سائر بلاد المسلمين والحمد لله رب العالمين.